glamorous, I'm looking to get her. Some going down to the store wearing trouble on my shirt. I work for the county out on 95. Although the whole red flag watch the traffic pass me by. In my head, I keep a picture of a pretty little miss. Someday, Mr. Rum, gonna lead a better life than this. Working on the highway late and down the blacktop. Getting on the highway all day long, I don't stop. Getting on the highway.
I'm pulling the spindles out and just kind of trying to assess the rust. It's pretty bad. I don't know if this can be saved or not. I think it can, but it was sitting out in the field, so this is be just in the nick of time because it was on its way to rusting completely through. It's got a pretty big dent right there. I got to get that pounded out. It doesn't hit the blade, but just get that pushed out. And then the guard here has worn through, as you can see, so I'll need to weld that back up together and reconnect it. And the old decal is all worn through. But this plate, I'm going to have to pull this plate off. This is a stiffener plate here, and it is completely rusted out on top. This whole thing, as you can see, it has a cover that sits over, and it's a really bad moisture trap. So I'm pulling the spindles off. I've got them all out, actually, and the bearings are in actually great shape. This needs to be cleaned out. This cap just spins around on top of this little unit, and it still moves, but needs to be cleaned out really well and de-rusted. And then I think I'm going to have to replace that spring on that idler right there. It's not doing its job right. Now let's see if we can get a look up underneath. It's actually not in bad shape. Just has normal rust for something that's been sitting out like this. But no rust through. I'll just have to get off, like I said, this stiffener plate right here and see what we got to work with underneath it. I don't know what I'll find under there. But
alright, I've removed all the bolts to the spindles.
Luckily these aren't threaded in through the deck or tapped. They just passed through, so it's a bolt and nut setup, which is good. One of them actually snapped off. It was over here on the spring return. It's hard to even see. It looks like I'm looking at a U-boat wreck or something here. This is so bad. But let's see here. So in here, there's that. There's a return pulley that bolts through the deck here, and then there's a bolt that holds the spring itself. The spring snapped off and broke, so I have to replace that, which I suspected it of being pretty weak anyway, so that's fine. And then there's a that bolt snapped too. The bolt that held it in there snapped, and then the spring in the end broke. So anyway, pretty rusty, but like I said, I think I got to this in the nick of time. It's pretty thrashed. But I'm going to go ahead and, like I said, I've got the bolts pulled off. And we're going to remove this, call it a stiffener plate. This plate that runs in here and adds a little bit of extra metal to it. It's a great idea, except for the fact that it's sitting in below. You can see where this cover sat. You know, they've got these covers that sit on top of these that cover the belt up. And maybe that's great for aesthetics, but looks, it's just a breeding ground for rust. It just stays damp in there. There's no gasket or anything to seal it out, which, you know, wouldn't help, but just stays completely damp. So I don't know what I'm going to do about that when I go to put this thing back together and repaint it or whatnot. But anyway, so this stiffener just sits under here, and then it's got, you know, whatever moisture is trapped between it and the deck. So not the greatest design you'll ever see. And you can see the end results here. But anyway, I'm going to set up and pull this plate off now that I've got the hardware off. All right, that came off pretty easily, actually. Boy, you can see the mess underneath that. Just soil and grit and rust, corrosion. But looks like the metal is intact and it's still hanging in there. Like I said, I've said this about 10 times now, but I think another couple of years in the field and not only the deck but the whole tractor would have really started to become unrecoverable. I know you can save them from some pretty severe rust, but I think I got it in the nick of time so that it's not been too hard to get going.